Is that pure Spartalfheim slag? Give it here. Whatever you need. Whatever you need, I'll create. That belonged to one of the rebels, didn't it?
These rigs come to be.
I had them built to harvest ore for armaments, essentially harnessing resources that would otherwise go to the dwarves.
You think shutting these things down will help the dwarves become independent?
I don't know, but I have to try something.
Is that a watchtower? Whoa, what? That geyser was huge!
Yes, it should lead us to the key for that watchtower door.
Thank you.
Ymir, how many stories have you told about Odin and Thor, and all the bad things they've done? Let's see how many we can remember.
Enough. We will continue later.
The key to that watchtower door should be on this island somewhere.
The ground looks weak down here, Father. That gear looks like it would freeze. Maybe that lift can help us get higher. Might be easier to break that ground from up there. What if we climbed over to the lift? Break through the ground from up there?
Left, left, left!
Ymir, is this it? We're here?
That's the key we're looking for. Now we must head to that watchtower on the shore.
What are you not saying?
The mining rigs are not the only sin I committed in Svartalfheim.
Ymir, what do you think it means? Seeing more raiders come back as Hellwalkers than you. I thought freeing the Valkyrie Queen was supposed to restore balance to the realms, and keep that from happening.
That's a good question, lad. And a troubling one. If Hell's filled up again, it suggests that something's been hindering Sigrun's efforts. Or perhaps something even more urgent is keeping her distracted and unable to visit, even occasionally.
Yeah. Sorry, Ymir.
There's another mining rig on this island, brother. Smell that smoke.
Why would the dwarves agree to work for the Aesir in the first place?
That's the heart of it, eh?
You lied to them.
I lied to them.
Bet we could swing across that, lift thing.
Gantry.
Thanks.
Not quite right.
It's got to be the right spot.
Those barrels. I smell fuel. Bet a spark from your blades would cause quite a boom.
Break through the ground here, if you found a high enough place to drop from. Yeah. surprised the dwarves didn't shut these rigs off themselves.
One or two tried. The Einherjar made examples of them.
They killed the dwarves? Can you have convinced them not to?
Aye. Impressive.
That should help.
I think we can reach it there.
Wasn't so hard. Okay, Mimir?
To the blacksmiths of Svartalfheim, the creation of a weapon was a sacred thing. But Odin just wanted as many blades as he could get, as fast as he could get them. With every stolen resource and mediocre blade, the dwarves lost a bit of themselves. You're not wrong there, brother. Odin would have wiped out every last dwarf in Svartalfheim. If he couldn't use their skills, no one could.
Back to Thor and Odin stories? Oh, whoa. Okay. There was Thalmor, the stonemason.
Aye. He quarreled with his son. Went into the night to find him. Found Thor instead.
And there was Thalmor's son, Hrimthor.
Who built the walls of Asgard. And whispered something of importance to Freya before his betrayal and assassination.
There was Groa, of course.
The knowledge keeper and prophet of Ragnarok. Thor murdered her husband. And Odin covered it up before doing her in himself.
You can't forget Ymir, the first giant.
Odin carved him up to form the realms from his body, and let the torrent of his blood nearly drown every giant alive.
What about the giants of Jotunheim? They all seemed dead when we finally made it there.
That remains a mystery. Well, admittedly, it sounds like the Aesir god's dream.
What about Fjorgyn? Thor's mother was a giant, wasn't she?
Indeed she was. The circumstances of her demise were murky at best, but not sure I can blame Odin for that one. He wasn't the same after.
Enough. We will continue later.
Hmph!
Can you hear that?
No.
Thought I heard a voice.
Let's keep going, lad. Just put the key into that lock, brother. There. If you could give that drum a good loud strike.
That's the voice I heard.
I'd hoped it would have escaped by now, but we'll need to free it from its restraints.
Loonbocker. I captured it many years ago.
For Odin?
Yes. I thought it an imaginative and eye-catching way to earn his favor.
It worked?
That it did.
This creature, you enslaved it.
Aye.
But why?
Because I was young and stupid. And I didn't know what it was like to be chained in one place for years at a time, with nothing to occupy your mind but pain.
Go!